Coming up.
Coming up.
Coming up.
Coming up.
Coming up.
Coming up.
On this week's news, the family of a man who lost an arm when he was electrocuted has called for changes in the law to stop it from happening again. Why heat batteries could be the future of home heating, and the government announces big spending on schools and hospitals. Welcome to Electrical News Weekly in association with Solar Trade Sales, your easy one-stop shop for all things solar. Make sure you click the link in the show notes to access their online store. Whether you're listening in the van, on site, or down at the wholesale counter, I'm Joe Robinson, and I've been through the best of the electrical industry news to save you the trouble. And this week's challenge word competition is supported by the good people at Brady. If you need a label, they've got a printer and so much more. If you think you've spotted the two words I've been challenged to slip into this week's show, comment with them below for the chance to win a prize. And while you're there, click the link to check out the Brady range of printers. The family of a window cleaner who lost his left forearm after surviving a 33,000 volt electric shock has called for changes in the law. Jason Knight from Westbury in Wiltshire thought he was going to die when the current arced from an overhead cable to his cleaning pole. He was in a customer's back garden at the time, and the force of the shock sent him flying 2 metres across the lawn, leaving scorched boot prints in the grass. The intense shock narrowly missed his heart, and he was flown to Southmead Hospital, where doctors performed no fewer than 17 operations to save his life. A preliminary report said that the power cables met the required safety standards and are recorded as having been inspected in 2023. Jason's father, John, said the first and second sections of a window cleaning pole are crucial for survival. He says the reason his son survived was because the section he was holding to operate the pole was insulated. The problem, he says, is that every other section is non-insulated. The Knight family want the handle and first section to be made to a British standard introduced in 2011 for any tool that may come into contact with overhead power lines. Still on protection, this week has seen the launch of a host of professional social media channels aimed at promoting safety among electricians. The charity, Electrical Safety First, which launched the channel, says it's responding to a surge in demand for information. It says downloads of its best practice guides have doubled year on year to nearly 37,000. The channels are called Elect Safety Pro, and they'll appear on all the major platforms, including Facebook, YouTube, TikTok, and Instagram. They'll deliver safety updates, expert insights, and the latest safe working practices. Don't forget to check out our own accredited CPDs on safe isolation and health and safety. You'll find links in the show notes. In other news, the government has announced that it's going to spend big on schools and hospitals in the coming years. In the first Labour budget for 14 years, Rachel Reeves said she'd invest an additional £100 billion in capital expenditure over the next 5 years. There's money for new homes, as well as £6.7 billion for schools, up 19%, and an extra £3 billion for hospital buildings. She's also given a £3.4 billion boost to the Warm Homes Plan, which is designed to help low-income households get clean energy. Also, contracting firms will have to pay more for employers' national insurance, and the minimum wage for apprentices will rise to £7.55 an hour. Speaking of clean energy, a major marketing campaign is set to alert the trade to a new opportunity in electric heating. Some experts are touting heat batteries as the next big thing. They say they could be a possible replacement for the traditional arrangement of a gas boiler and radiators that's used in no fewer than 23 million homes in the UK. So, what's a heat battery? Well, simply put, it's a night storage heater which builds up thermal energy during off-peak hours and then releases it gradually during peak hours the following day. Haven't we had them for years, I hear you ask? Well, yes, we have. But unlike storage heaters, heat batteries are specifically designed to integrate into existing wet heating systems. This way, households can get rid of their gas boilers without replacing their radiators. The gas units are replaced with what's termed a zero emissions boiler. That's where the heat is stored, not in the radiators. Inside is a core of magnetite, a mineral which has very high energy density. During low peak times, this can be heated to over 800 Celsius. An internal heat exchanger connects this to the existing radiator network. The beauty for householders is that it's a simple switch with less disruption than other technologies. The downside is that zero emission boilers are much more expensive than gas ones. The leading brand, Tipio, costs £6,000. They're also larger and need more maintenance and servicing. Tipio says that installers can learn to fit a heat battery in less than a day. It's a suitable job for electricians, as you don't need gas safety or refrigerant training that would be required for gas boilers or heat pumps respectively. So you could soon be running amok through plumbing territory. I've put a link to more info in the show notes. Still on clean energy, Tesco has announced that it's buying enough solar energy to power 144 of its large stores. Britain's largest supermarket chain said it's committing to purchasing 65% of the power generated by Cleve Hill Solar Park in Faversham, Kent. The site is home to the UK's largest solar and battery storage project, with a capacity of 373 megawatts of solar and 150 megawatts of energy storage. It's set to become operational in early 2025. And speaking of clean energy, this week sees the winners of the eFIXX Awards 2024 being announced. We'll be letting you know who's the raddest renewables installer, the most excellent EV installer, and which college is the cream of the crop this year. So stay tuned across our social channels to see who's won, and make sure to record and share your reaction videos. If anyone manages to be more excited than Neo Electrical Solutions, we'll be impressed. In other news, an unlikely champion of electrical apprenticeships has emerged in the shape of Elon Musk. The world's richest man told a rally in America that a university education is often overrated. Students graduate with big debts without acquiring relevant job skills. He said it was simply not true that a degree was necessary for success. Instead, the world needs hands-on professions, and the mischievous Mr. Musk put electricians at the top of his list. However, he could be doing young people a disservice if a new survey is to be believed. An analysis of 2,000 online comments about working life conducted by digital public relations agency Bubblegum Search has named the unhappiest profession as electricians. According to the study, the physically demanding nature of the job and the 40 plus hour weeks weren't made up for by its decent salary. Other unhappy professions include social workers and night cleaners. The happiest jobs include cybersecurity engineers, video game developers, and dog photographers. So what could be done to make a career on the tools more satisfying? Let us know in the comments below. Our suggestion is that you enter a competition to win big with BG circuit protection designed with electricians for electricians. You could win one of a range of prizes, including a European city break, tickets to the MotoGP, a Porsche driving experience, a Merlin annual pass, and many more. Entering couldn't be simpler. Just buy a product from the BG circuit protection range, excluding accessories, upload your receipt or invoice at bgwin.co.uk, and you'll be entered into the prize draw to win big. And you can enter as many times as you like by purchasing more kit and uploading the receipts. The only way to guarantee you won't win is not to enter. Take that, dog photographers. In product news this week, Metrel has unveiled a multifunction tester for solar systems. The MI3114 is designed for installs with a maximum system voltage of 1,500 volts and a maximum short circuit current of 40 amps. The tester comes with an array of accessories for comprehensive testing, including a remote unit for measuring irradiation and cell temperature. You can test strings in parallel with a 40 amp current, and there's an auto test function for the IEC EN62446 Category 1 tests. The Metrel unit is set to compete with the Fluke's 283 FC meter, which was launched last week. City Electrical Factors has unveiled a smart energy management system for domestic applications. The Swarm Hub 1 is a central controller for home energy. CEF says it optimises the performance of renewable devices by using the weather forecast and real-time energy tariffs to help customers maximise their savings. Hub 1 also receives local info on sunshine so that solar power can be optimised. CEF says it's a great way for electricians to get into energy management. It says installers can have the system up and running in just 30 minutes. It's also promising that next year the hub will be able to connect to Swarm's virtual power plant so that homeowners can sell surplus energy back to the grid at premium rates. And our usual reminder that we're in the market for your stories, your projects, and your recommendations, as we'd like to share them with the wider eFIXX community. During November, we'll be looking at commercial EV charging, testing equipment, and innovations within the electrical industry. Send us pictures of your installs, or let us know if you've come across any new kit that's making your job easier. Now, just before we get to your favourite bit of the show, where I reveal last week's challenge words and winners, we want to thank our premium partners. We couldn't make the news without you. First up, it's the people who've created the Swiss Army knife of solar inverters, along with all-weather batteries, very much the Boy Scouts of the solar industry, it's SunSync. Up next, they're resolving ventilation problems one property at a time, offering a simplistic ventilation design service and high-quality products made right here in the UK, breathing fresh air into your home, it's Envirovent. The best thing to come out of Yorkshire since Stainless Steel, the home of EV Ultra and other groundbreaking and quality products, it's Doncaster Cables. With an incredible range of equipment from EV charge points through industrial sockets and switches to kit for explosive areas, plus they supplied gear for a Campari factory, so they'll always have a place in my heart, it's Scarmy. Big thanks to you all. We really appreciate your ongoing support for the news. If you think you know the words that I've smuggled into this week's show, pop your guess into the comments. We'll take all the correct guesses and select one at random to be the winner of an eFIXX goodie bag prize. Answers submitted after about lunchtime on the Thursday after release will not be entered into the draw. Now let's reveal the winner of last week's Challenge Word competition as sponsored by Brady. Remember, if you need a label, they've got a printer and so much more. Click the link in the description to view their incredible range. Last week's words were Archbishop and Waylaid, and they were obviously a little trickier as not as many people got them right, but the winner we plucked from our digital hat was Dave Frizzell 3882. Excellent work, Dave. Make sure you click the Get Involved link in the show notes to claim your prize. Thanks for listening to this episode of Electrical News Weekly in association with Solar Trade Sales, your easy one-stop shop for all things solar. Remember to click the link in the show notes to check out their online shop. Make sure you subscribe to receive the next update. Thanks for listening, and until next time, have a great week. Stay safe out there, and remember, there's no such thing as a torque-calibrated arm.